Good afternoon, and thanks for joining back. This is Life Talk with Alaja Brown. My name is Angelique, and I don't know what the network is like at your end now, if it's better. Thank you, Auntie Olanike Yola Olufemi. Thanks, ma, for joining. Thank you, my darling, my Olufemi Olusheyi Chobande. Thank you very much for joining. Thank you, Auntie Stella and Cole. Thank you very much for joining. Mr. Amusa Deniye, thank you very much for joining. Where am I going to? I don't understand, but where am I going to? Mr. Amusa Deniye, thank you. Thank you very much for joining in. Can I please employ that you share on your page and let me know what the network is doing at your end, if it's okay. If it's not, I don't know what I'm going to do about it because I've just tried to sort it out now. My topic today is child sexual molestation and paedophile. Child sexual molestation, paedophile, and then parental neglect and social dysfunction. Thank you very much, Abdullahi Adam Basuna. Thank you very much for joining. Today, I'm not going to be doing the talking alone. You guys will ring in today, and I'll hear from you guys as well. The telephone number in the UK is 074-026-0077. It's 074-026-0077. People that will be ringing in from Nigeria, the number is +44742-260077. The lines are not open yet. I'll let you know when it's gonna be open, when you can tell me what you think about what this topic is about. Thank you, Olutayo Yekini. Thank you very much, Balogun Rashida. Thank you very much for joining. The reason why this topic has come to heart is a few days ago on the group, a few of you know about the incident that went on. I did see a cartoon post about paedophile and sexual molestation on a young child. And there's this cartoon where an adult lady is sat down and a young child is being sexually abused. And it did worry me, and I did even cry when I saw the post. And some people had to report to Facebook to say it's distressing to them or whatever it is. And they did contact me, and they did their investigation. And it's all right to talk about it. It's just that they didn't want the graphics to be shown to people because there's a lot of paedophile around these days lately. And that is why this topic has come to my mind. Or a mini Alaja Brown. Mo soro nipa awon omo wa ibi ta ngbe awon omo wa si ki lo nsele iru ibalopo wo ni awon ta nfi awon omo wa ti iru ki no nse fa awon omo wa se amo nkan ton se pelu awon omo wa gbogbo oro ti ma so leni yi lori awon omo wa ni awo obi ibi ta ngba awon omo wa si bawo ni a se ri be yen si. Se okan wa dun si ibi ta n gbo mo wa si. Child molestation, paedophile, where are you dropping your child? Are you certain where you're dropping your child? What do you think is happening when you're not there? I have seen instances. I have heard a lot of things that I'm going to share with you guys today. And it'll be lovely. Like I said, this is Life Talk with Alaja Brown. I'd like to thank everybody that's been participating in my group on my page. Thank you very much. People who has been following me on YouTube, people who have been, thank you, BC Makinde, for joining back. Rachel Parks, thank you very much, darling. Ise Sores, I cannot speak English alone. I'll mix it up because I have my audience as well. Some of them do not understand English. So I'll mix it. Whatever I say in Yoruba will definitely be repeated in English. I speak more of English than Yoruba, but I'll try and balance it. Thank you very much. Where are we sure where we're putting our child at? Is our children safe? Where do we know? What do we know is happening to our children when we leave them with families and friends? When we leave them with minders that are not registered? I am now going to talk about Nigeria. Where are you leaving your children? Are you leaving your children with grandparents? Are you leaving your children with friends? What is happening there when you are not there? What is happening when your children are not in school and they are with a friend or they are with family members? I'm going to talk about my ordeal as well. I'm going to share my ordeal with you, what's happened to me in the past, and I'm going to share what I've heard because I have done a lot of research about this topic with you guys. I don't know if you have shared so that I can get a larger audience, please. Thank you very much. Like I said, the number we're going to be ringing in later today is 0740266007. Ago ibanisoro ta le pe sile ni yi ni odo eje erin odo eji efa efa odo odo ati eje eje. En to ba npe lati Nigeria e gbudo fi plus erin erin eje eyo odo to wa ni be kuro eje erin odo eji mefa meji odo meji ati meje meji lati le pe wole ti ago ero ibanisoro ba si sile lati le pe wole. What I've just said is people who would like to ring in from Nigeria, the number to ring in from Nigeria, you have to add the plus 4474026007. That's the number that you'll ring in later to tell me what you think and what has happened and how parents need to adjust to where they put in their children. Right, straight to my topic of today. There's a lot of maniac people around. The world is turned around. It's not what it used to be like. Where are you putting your children? Where are you putting your children? It's not people in psychiatric hospitals and mental institutions that are sick. A lot of people are sick, but they are not in mental institution or psychiatric hospital. A lot of people are spiritually and mentally sick. A lot of people, God knows what comes into them, what they think before when they start doing things. Where are you putting your child? Where are you putting your children? The child minder you're leaving your child with, what is happening? Because a lot of African people, we tend to leave our children with non-registered child care. When you leave your child there, what do you think is happening? Let's leave the physical appearance, because a lot of us see that person as someone who is beautiful in the face and wouldn't harm a fly. Who is your friend? Because a lot of us, before you leave your child with a friend, it has to be someone you trust. It has to be families. I'm going to go back to families as well, because there are some families that cannot be trusted as well. So, and I remember years ago, I wanted to leave my son with a friend to go for a birthday party that I wouldn't be there. And another friend of mine turned around and said to me, she said, "Do you know this person?" I says, "Oh yes, I do know this person." She says, "How many times do you go out and eat? How many times do you do things together? How many times has she come to your place to have a sleepover? How many times have you been to her place to have a sleepover?" Then it dawned on me that I actually don't really know that person. The person you're leaving your children with, how much do you know them? Because a lot of us can, from afar, we know this person because we're trying to save money. Because we are in Europe, we are in the UK, we are in the US, France, Germany, Spain, wherever we are. We're trying to save money. We leave our children with people. The person you are leaving your child with might be a very good person. Is what's the husband like? What's the wife like? What the people that are going to be in that environment at that time, what is the person like? That is why when they talk about registered child care, it means someone who is registered. Some people have their registered care home, child care in the comfort of their own home, and you cannot go there and visit them if you're not invited, because by law it's been registered that there's a certain amount of people that can be in that environment at that time. But someone who is not registered, because you're saving £10 or £15, you leave your child all night. Your female child, the husband is gone out, he's drunk, he's coming, the wife is refused. What is happening to your girl child? The wife is being starved of sexual intercourse. And you have a male child there. What is happening to your child? While I was doing my research, I spoke with a friend, a sister of mine, and she gave me an instance of what happened in her life. She said she normally leaves her child with her mother in the UK. She's an European lady, a white lady. She says she normally leaves her child with her mother. Unfortunately, the mother always goes out, and she has this 19-year-old girl that lives down the road, who always like, oh, can I have your son? Can I have your son? And the grandmother was like, oh, obviously, this young lass likes children, and she left. When grandmom receives child, she passes child over to the young lass that lives down the road. And a month, 2 months down the line, when she was giving her son a bath, the son started saying, "Mom, don't touch my willy. Mom, don't touch my private parts." And that child is only 3 years old at that time. And she was so, so worried, thinking, what is going on? And she said she sat her son down and asked, why should I not touch your private part? And how do you know it's called private part? And she did mention that so-so-so person said it's called a private part and nobody can touch it except that person. So she had to stand up. She took her son to her mother and asked, mother, who is so-so-so person? And the mother turned around and said, is the young lass that lives down the road. So she said she was so inquisitive and she had to meet up for a drink with, I'll just tag her as Miss A. So she went down the road to have a drink with Miss A, and fortunately or unfortunately, the child wanted to use the toilet, the three-year-old child. The three-year-old child wanted to use the toilet. So she wanted to take her son to the toilet, and the son said no, he didn't want to go to the toilet with his mother. He wanted Miss A to take him to the toilet. And she thought maybe the child just likes Miss A and that's okay. She said she'd sat there for half an hour, being in the toilet, they weren't back, before they eventually got back. And when they got back, Miss A put the three-year-old child on her laps and they were talking. And while they were gisting, she said she saw her child touching the private part of Miss A. She said, but she didn't want to be ridiculous or take it out of proportion. She thought, she said she just was in her mind, she's just thinking she's not going to be paranoid about it. But when they stood up and they were about to go home, she said her three-year-old smacked the bottom of Miss A. And she faced the child and says, "Why did you do that?" She said, her son said, "Mom, Miss A said I could do anything I want with that." And at that time, Miss A was already shivering. When she got home, her mother started shouting and say, "Why would you say it's okay for my grandson to tap you on the bottom?" Right, when they got home, she couldn't sleep. They had to call the police. Social services had to be involved. They had to put a child and gave the child dolls to explain what really happened. This is true life story. And while she was the child was explaining, the mother was crying because Miss A said she could, the three-year-old could put his mouth in her private part, could play with her breast, could suck it, could do a lot of horrible things. Where are we putting our children? Because we are all eager to make money. We are all eager to go to work. We do the someone who hasn't got a CRB check. Someone we especially in Nigeria. Thank you very much, Kola Wale Oyeyemi. Thank you very much. We leave our children with child in Nigeria. We have house help. We leave our children with house help. What is happening? I learned a story of a male house help, whereby the house help. This is a very sad one. It's okay, darling. Anytime I'm here in the next few minutes. While I was doing my research, I have heard of house help that are sucking, that are asking children to suck their private parts. I have heard a lot of things that are disturbing. A lot of people are spiritually and mentally sick upstairs. Where are you leaving your child? What is happening? I heard of a story of a man who, when his wife goes out to buy milk for the child, because the child is crying, he puts his private part in the child's mouth to suck so that he keeps quiet. And the child's tummy was getting bigger and bigger. It was until the NHS, they had to get the child in and see what was happening. And then they realized that the child was sucking sperm. A baby. The mother went to buy milk. I can't even remember what child's milk is like now. Aptamil in the store. And before he got back, she noticed the child won't cry again. She noticed the child had big tummy. What was going on? Eventually, they realized that he was a pedophile. The child was sucking his private part and the child's stomach was getting bigger and bigger. Where are you leaving your child? Do you trust your husband enough? There's so many sick people going on. There's so many sick things happening. I was talking with a friend of mine who said since her childhood, her father has been sleeping with her. She grew up with knowing well her father was sleeping with her. But she dare not tell her mom because her dad said he was going to kill her. What is happening? Are you praying enough? It's the end time. What is happening where you are? Where do you know your child is? What is happening in this world? It's okay not to show graphic pictures, but these things are things that are happening day in, day out. Especially in Nigeria. I heard a story when I put the post up. When I put the post up, I heard a guy who did comment and said the person that was abusing the toddler was his grandmother. The grandmother was allowing the child have sexual intercourse with her, a child less than 10 years of age. And this is a black Nigerian family. Because sometimes we tend to take our mind off facts. We tend to think it only happened in the white community. It is wrong. It's happening amongst us. It's happening where you are. You leave your child, especially Nigeria. Our Nigeria. A ma fi awon mo wa sile nbi ton ti ma sere. Ibi to fi omo e si. Won sere nita. O mo ile ti omo e wo to ti lo jeun. O mo ile ti omo e wo to ti lo sere. O mo nkan to n ba omo e se ninu ile. What is happening where you are? Hello, OJ Willex. Thank you very much for joining. Kingsley Ogbona, thank you very much for joining me today. Bishop Ade, thank you very much for joining. Bosun Bosman, he says, thank you for joining. He says, this is a serious problem in our society. It's a sign of end times. OJ Willex says, it's a very big issue. It's a big issue for me because it's worrying me. It's worrying me. I remember when I was younger, this person that was abusing me at that time is dead now. Because what he used to do, he would say, I should hold his private parts. And I'm talking 70s. A lot is happening. It has been before, it's now, and ever shall be. World without end. It's been happening. What is happening in your society? This thing I'm saying, I never told my parents in my life. I never. And my parents weren't harsh people. There were people I could talk to, but I would never go in to talk to them. Because at that time, that uncle of mine said I didn't have the right to say anything. What is happening? Where are we putting our children? Then we turn around, we are scared that our children is being a gay, is being a lesbian, because they are traumatized. They are traumatized. A lot of our children, what's happened to them, it's made them traumatized. Then they grow up, they don't want to be involved with a man. And a lot of them don't want to be involved with a woman. Because you will see your male son doesn't want to get involved with a woman. Because a woman has traumatized the child when growing up. Then you are there, you are crying. The time you are meant to be at home, pulling your child together and wanting to know what's happened, where your child has been, you're not wanting to do that. You are going to party. We are not our children's friends to know what they are going through, where they are. Where are you putting your child? What is happening where you are putting your child? When you put your child there and they get home, are you talking to them? Are you asking them questions? It's not that you don't trust where they're putting them. It's just that you need to know what is happening where they are. The lines are opened if you want to ring in, guys. You can ring in and tell me your opinion about what this topic is about. Oro wadale lori leni. Lori bita ngbo mo wa si, ibo lo nfo mo e si, ibo la nfo mo wa si, ibo le nfo mo yin si. Te ba lo bi se, te fo mo yin si le. Ki lo nsele ni bi te fo mo yin si. Elomi nu yin e fo mo yin si le pelu iya yin tabi baba yin. Ki le mo boya won se fo mo yin. Eyin te ngbo mo yin lo si le child minder nitori pe e fe sanwo child care to won. Ibo ni en gbo omo yin si ki lo nsele pelu omo yin ki lo nse pelu omo yin mo ranti oro kan eyan kan so fun mi lojo kan o ni omo un so pe mom I don't want to go to so place onu n bere pe ki lo why do you don't want to go there onu omo un so pe tenti mommy lagbaja ba we mi o ma n foko mi sere oko mi wa n du mi ọmọdún mẹ́fà ló ń sọ bẹ́ẹ̀ sí ìyá ẹ̀ ibo ló ń fọmọ ẹ sí ìgbà tó bá fọmọ ẹ síbẹ̀ tó lọ́bi iṣẹ́ tó dé ṣó ń bámọ ẹ sọ̀rọ̀ ṣó ń bèèrè nǹkan tó ṣẹlẹ̀ ń bẹ̀ẹ̀ pẹ̀ lọ́wọ́ ọmọ ẹ má fi ọ̀rọ̀ sẹ́nu ọmọ ẹ jẹ́ kí ọmọ ẹ kó sọ̀rọ̀ fún ẹ jẹ́ ọ̀rẹ́ ọmọ ẹ ìwọ obìnrin jẹ́ ọ̀rẹ́ ọmọ ẹ baba baba gbogbo aye ni o omo omo ti e ni o mo ranti aye igba kan mama mi ani ti le ba shu omo onikaluku ma wonu ile iya e iwo lo lomo e so fe kan ba ye omo e je ko to di ore omo eni se pati nikan lo nro ni se pati nikan ni gbogbo ori e lo fi nro igba wo lo po omo e joko omo e kekere omo e ti o ti idibalaga ton bere lowo e pe ibi to wa yen ki no nse fun nibe so like ibe yen ki lo je nbe iya lagbaja bawo lo se we so nbo omo e soro Daniel Chinekwe, all I have said in English is what I'm saying to my Yoruba fans as well. Thank you very much. I will go back to English in a few minutes. I'm trying to explain to my Yoruba fans who do not understand everything I have said in English just now. I'm just doing a recap for them. Ibo lo nfo mo esi, ki no nse fun mo e nibi to wa. Ki no nse fun omo e obirin nibi to wa. Elomi omo e obirin lati omo odun meje. Nibi to n fomo e si ni okunrin tin towo bo abe omo e ibo lo n fomo e si ki lo n sele nbi to n fomo e si nani to ni ko lo tamba fomo e ni bathroom ni Naija se ko towo bo abe omo e nani to ni ko lo tamba fomo e okunrin se ko ma towo bo furo omo e ibo lo n fomo e si where are you putting your children? What is happening where you are putting your children? I will just read through what a few people have said. BC Makinde, she says, honestly, I can't stop crying. It's so sad hearing things like this. It is my darling sister. Abdullahi Adam Basunu, he says, good talk, my sister. God bless you. Thank you very much. Daniels Chinekwe, he says, great parents should teach their kids the way of God and pray for them because you might not be everywhere they are. That's right. You cannot be everywhere your child is. That is why I'm saying you have to be your children's friend. You have to teach your children sex education. You have to let them understand there's nobody who has the right to touch their private parts. You have to let them know it's their special prized possession they have to look after. You have to make them understand that there is okay if anybody touches it, it's okay to come and tell me what happened. You have to let them understand if they tell you, if you say they are going to be in trouble, let them understand what people can say to them while that will make them not be able to talk. BC Jacobs, Biscop Ade says, you are absolutely right. Thank you very much. Oluwayemisi Adebimpe Oyewumi. He said, may God save us all. End time has come. It's very common in Nigeria. I have been through this scene, my dear sister. Thank God my mother later take action because it's very good mother to listening. Oh, God bless you, ma. God bless you too. Thank you very much. Jade's Design Culture. She says, may God destroy such wicked people. Amen. Amen. OJ Willett. He says, oh my God, this is more reason you are a lady with wisdom. We are all praying for wisdom. Nobody has full wisdom. We are all praying. It's just that pinch that God has given us. But thank you very much. God will always keep you going in life. And you too, God bless you. Jayola Michael O, he says, this is a big issue. Daniel, yeah, I'll just continue. Thank you, Ajenike, Adesuyi. Thank you very much for joining. The number is open now. If you are ringing from the UK, it's 07402660077. If you are ringing from outside in Nigeria, it's +74026006007. I'll just put it on screen. The number is there on screen for everyone who wants to ring in and tell me their experience and ordeal about it. And people who are ringing in from Nigeria, the number has to have plus because a lot of my Nigerian fans keep saying the number is not real. The number is real. The number goes through. But because you are ringing via MTN, Econet, some people said Econet says they don't have the number. It's a UK number. Feel free to ring in and let us know what you think about what I have discussed today. The number is there on screen. If you scroll up, you'll see it. Thank you very much if you're calling in. Can I please ask, don't ring on this my mobile phone, the main number that I'm if you got to ring, you have to ring on and can I please say don't inbox my Facebook at the moment, because I won't be able to reply you if I am online. Where are you putting your children? What is happening to your child? If a friend of mine was telling me about she used to have a child care years ago, and when she went to work, she was doing a night shift. She says when she goes, she comes back in the morning, she says her child always sleeps all morning, and she used to think, why is this child sleeping all morning? Does he not sleep at night? It was later she realized it. Then she went to visit the child minder during the day, and she realized that the child minder did not remove the children off the pushchair. The child minder did not remove all the other children from their pushchairs. The child minder was claiming, you cannot kill me. Your mother is at work making money. You cannot kill me. Meanwhile, the parents are paying for child care. That was what the woman was saying. You cannot kill me. Your mother has gone to work. And she strapped the children on the pushchair. She never took them out. She gave them their bottle there. The children cried until their parents came to pick them up. Then she realized that her child was also strapped in the pushchair on a night shift while she was at work. Where are you putting your child? What is happening where you are putting your child? What is happening where you are putting your child? I'm not saying they are not responsible people that look after children. That is not what I'm saying. They are responsible people, but there's the law of pedophile around at the moment. There are a lot of sick people who have dysfunctional brains in the society at the moment. People like you and I, who are dressed gorgeously, who you would never think such a thing with them, who you would never in the slightest ever think they could do it, they are doing it. Where are you putting your child? What is happening where you leave your child? What is happening there? What is happening there? Imagine the case of the guy who, when his wife goes to buy milk, he puts his private part in the child's mouth to suck. And when he comes in the child's mouth and the child drinks it. What is happening where you're leaving your child? What is happening? Imagine the story of the grandmother that was allowing her grandson have sexual intercourse with her. And she's a Muslim. She prays 5 times a day. She's a normal person like you and I. Where are you leaving your child? Where are you leaving your children? A friend of mine said, his son said, anytime he goes to so woman's place, when she bats me, mom, she plays with my thing. Which thing? It was touching his private part. Then he was scared. Then the mom says, no, don't be scared, sweetheart. Tell me, how does she touch it? Did you like it? Just trying to make the child comfortable to be able to talk about it. Thank you, Sister Dolapo Adeyekun. Thank you for joining. Thank you, Sister Margaret Iyabode Adebanjo. Thank you, ma, for joining. Paul O. Ojo, thank you very much for joining. Thoughtful assignments. May God speak the lives through you and through you to my brother. God bless you. Thank you very much. Where are you leaving your child? Nigeria is worse. Nigeria is worse. You leave your child with your friend. You leave your child with your friend, you go to work. You go into a party, you leave your child with your friend. You go into a party, you leave your child with your house help. What is happening? A man can abuse a man. A man can abuse a young boy. It's not only a man to a woman. Yes, we know a woman, a young girl can be abused even by a young girl. Yes, you leave your child with your female friend. You think the female friend cannot abuse your child? You must be joking. Because if your female tells your child to sleep on the bed and start putting her finger in your female child's private part, it's an abuse. How much do you know your friend? How well do you know your friend? Please, how well do you know your friend? Like I was giving you an instance of my friend wanted to go, my son wanted to go to a party next door, a few doors away. And I had visitors around and I didn't want to go to that party at that time. But my son could just cross the road and go. And I called my friend and I says, I'm going to send my son over to you. And the lady had to tell me, she says, no, how much do you know that person? They're having a party, that means the person will be so busy, even if I trust that person, might be so busy to see my child. There might be pedophiles around that area. My child wants to go to the toilet. I'm not there. It might be one adult, he goes to the bathroom, and one adult shuts the door on my child. What is going to happen? You have to be vigilant with your children. We have to be vigilant with our children. Ibo lomo e wa irere wo lomo e ba won ton to wa lodo won irere wo no ba won se ba wo lo se mo awon iyen si. Please do not inbox me, please. I want, because I, please do not inbox me, please, because I'm using my phone. Please, I'm using my phone. The number you can inbox in or call in is 0740266007. If it's private, you can do a WhatsApp on it. I can read it out. If you think it's private, you need to talk about it. The phone is here. You can send me a message on it. It's 0740266007. If you want to ring in and talk about it, I'll feel free to ring in and discuss with it. I have a WhatsApp on that number. If it's concerning this topic, I'll read it out. I'll go through it and read it out and make you anonymous if you want to be anonymous. That's fine with me. Where thank you, Adebayo Isaac Ekunjayo, thank you very much for joining. Thank you, Maris. Thank you very much for joining. Thank you, Lukman Fanny. Thank you very much. Yomi Olujobi, thank you very much, my brother. Ruth Becky, thank you very much for joining in. Mantifola Shade Oluweri Queen, thank you very much for joining. She says, God should help us with all these fake friends. Amen. And she also says, well done, my darling sister. Thank you very much, auntie. Thank you very much. I appreciate. Like I was saying with my Yoruba fans, Ibo lo ngbo mo esi. Oun lo party ofi omo esinu le pelu omo odo. Oun lo party ofi omo esile pelu ore nitori o so pe oun o lo. Ki lo mo pe o nsele si omo e. Sojo ore si omo e lati le mo nkan to nsele. Komo e le salaye fun e. A lot of us are scared of sex education with our young ones. You don't have to talk about how they have sexual intercourse. There's lots of ways to think that you can explain sex education to your child. If you have a, like my children, when they were 5 years old and I leave them when I used to work years ago, when I leave them, I just tell them, nobody must touch your kokoro. If anybody wants to touch it, say my mom says no. Nobody must clean your bottom for you. Leave the poo in your bottom, I will clean it when you get home. Wherever how much you clean it, that is how much you bring it home for me. I'm fine, I will look after you. And if anybody tells you they are doing something, if you tell your mom you'll be in trouble, it's a lie. You will never be in trouble with me. Thank you, Adebayo Isaac Ekunjayo. Thank you, all my friends in Abuja. Thank you very much for joining in. All my friends in Lagos, thank you very much for joining in. All my fans in Port Harcourt, I appreciate you. In the US, thank you very much. In the UK as well, I appreciate every one of you. And I tell my children, if anybody tells you, if you tell me anything, you'll be in trouble. I says, have you ever been in trouble with me? No, you will never be in trouble with me. Feel free to tell me. And when they come back, I see they're doing somehow, I call them. What's happened there? What's happened with your kokoro? Did anybody touch you? What happened to you? What did you do there? When did you eat? How did you eat? These are the questions I ask my children. Don't get me wrong. It's not that I don't trust the people that they're with. It's just that sometimes children are worried about things they can't tell that person, and it's you, the parent, they need to discuss that them things with. Be your children's friend. And your biri and you yami and you nima basoro. E jore omo yi. Omo du marun omo koton shele. Omo du meri omo koton shele. Je ore omo e. Da bobo omo e. Ragabu omo e. Iwo lo ni omo e. Tile ba shu. Inu li e lomo e ma wo. When night falls, your child is coming to your house. Your children are yours to guide their steps and look after. That is why God has given you that child to bring up. God knows you are capable of looking after that child. That's why he has given you this child, not for you to go and drop with your friend. If you know you are not ready to take full responsibility of your child, use a condom. Use a condom. And can I just chip in? A lot of us, we see our four-year-old, we will be having sexual intercourse in their presence. A lot of parents have sexual intercourse in the presence of their three-year-olds. They say, omo yo ti mon kokon. They emarun rayi. Emarun rayi. Omo ya ma wo yi. Bo se yo ku e jade, omo en wo e. Anu en se mi o. Then you will come back and say your child's life is destroyed. You will come back when your child is 10 years old, is looking for a woman to sleep with. Stop traumatizing your children. Your child is only 3 years old. You are sleeping with your child in your presence. Your child is on the bed with you. Your husband is sleeping with you in the presence of your child. This world has turned around. If they used to do it in the 19 Gbogboro, it doesn't happen these days. You should not be having sexual intercourse where your child is sitting down and looking at you. You shouldn't. Please. Please. I was talking to someone. She said at 4 years old, she's a UK born and breded. She's a Nigerian. She says at 4 years old, everything, the way her father had sexual intercourse with her mother, she knows it. That is like it's there. If your child is younger than a year old, that's a different thing. If your child is between 0 and 1 year old, that's okay. But when your child is from half over a year old, please don't do it. Don't do it. The devil will not use you to teach your children bad things. Don't do it. I know someone who called me. They inboxed me. And I said she should ring me. She says, my son is 5 years old and my husband has intercourse in his presence while he's sleeping beside me. But when I tell him it's not right, he says, my son, the child, doesn't know anything. Please stop it. Please. If you're managing, especially those people in London, if a
managing and you have only one room, go to your boyfriend's house. If managing you have only one room, do your sexual intercourse in your children's school. Remember Nigeria years ago, you are sleeping on the floor. Your daddy and mommy are doing they are doing their thing up there. You can hear them, you can see them, but they will think you are sleeping. Then you will keep quiet. You will keep quiet, but you can hear your parents having sexual intercourse. Especially from the middle home and the poor home. Yes. People who live in face you may face you. That your parents could not afford anything. And it's just one room. The four of you are sleeping on the floor. Three of you are sleeping on the floor. Your daddy and mommy are up there. You could hear them. But because we are holding these children, it's okay. But now we are in a civilized world. The children see everything. They know everything. They know everything. Please teach your children sex education. Teach your children sex education. When I mean teach your children sex education, I do not mean teach them how a man and a woman climbs on each other. No. I mean teach them how to protect their private parts. Thank you, Ugochi Njoku. Nice. She says nice words here. Thank you very much. Adejobi Badmo Said. Thank you very much. Adebayo, yes, I know. Adiola Awek, thank you very much, my darling sister. Jade says, she says, it's a very bad situation, which is the root of many sexual abuses. It is. It is. Because when your children are traumatized, they grow up, your girl child grows up, she's been abused by a man, she grows up, and she says she doesn't want to get married to a man. She wants to either stay with a woman or remain single. And you start praying and casting out the demon. And meanwhile, the demon was your negligence. Your demon was your negligence. Your male child grows up, he's been abused by your housemaid, he's been abused by his grandmother, he's been abused by his daddy. Your male child grows up and turns around and tells you he doesn't want to have anything to do with a woman. He wants to be doing a man. And you are worried and you are casting out the demon. Meanwhile, the demon should have been casted out from the beginning of the child's life, which you blindly ignored because you were too busy making money. Where are you putting your children? Ibolon Fomwesi. Where are you putting your children? Ibolon Fomwesi. Kilon Shele Nibito Fomwesi. What is happening where you are putting your children? What is happening there where you are putting your children? Everybody needs to check him or herself. Someone cannot bring their child to me now and they say maybe the mother sleeps overnight and expect me to give birth to give their child a shower. No, I can put on the shower and tell that child to go in. Because I don't want a situation whereby because maybe the child's been abused somewhere else and I touch the child and they think I'm abusing the child. The children that they are bringing to your place, as soon as the child is 5 years, because in nursery, they clean their bottom. And we all know nursery starts at age of 3 in the UK. So why would I send my child somewhere and they are cleaning my child's bottom and they are putting their finger in either her private part or his bottom or playing with his willy? When they go to the creche, they clean their bottom themselves. When they go to nursery, they clean their bottom themselves, even at a young age, as early as 3 years old. Teach your children how to care for their personal hygiene. Don't make your children a mommy's child. Don't make your children, don't put your child under your armpit to the extent that your child will not be able to handle his or her personal hygiene. We are so busy with work. We are so busy with fashion. We are so busy with party. We are so busy going to church. We are so busy going to mosque, trying to be a scholar. Meanwhile, we are not looking after the thing, the most important thing God has given us access to look after. Then we blame it on religion. We blame it that it's the devil that's entered them. We blame it on a Shatan. Meanwhile, when a Shatan started a long time ago. Where are you putting your child? What is happening where you are putting your child? What abuse or trauma is your child going through? Ladies and gentlemen, can I just employ us to please be number one, be your child's friend. Be your child's friend. Let your child be comfortable to talk to you. Let your child be comfortable to discuss things with you. When your child goes out and come back, be comfortable to talk to your children about it. Excuse me. Sorry about that. Be your child's friend. Let your child be comfortable to talk to you. Explain to your child what is on his body and how he can protect it. Let your child understand that he can look after his hygiene himself. Teach your children how to have a shower by themselves, whether they are clean or not, how they can manage it before you come back. Let your child know. Let your child understand that no matter what anybody tells them not to say, they are allowed to talk to you. Even if they're not going to say it to anybody, it's you that they need to tell it to. And talk to your child, they have to keep the secrets with you. Anything anybody tells them not to say, they're allowed to say it to you, you will keep the secret. Let your child be your best friend. And you'll be ring, Efa ẹjọ́ ọ̀rẹ́ sí àwọn ọmọ yín yálà ọkùnrin àbóbìnrin ẹjọ́ ọ̀rẹ́ sí àwọn ọmọ yín ẹ jẹ́ kí àwọn ọmọ yín kán lè bá yín sọ̀rọ̀ ẹ má máa pariwo mọ́ àwọn ọmọ yín jù ẹ má máa jágbe mọ́ àwọn ọmọ yín jù ẹ kọ́ àwọn ọmọ yín mọ́ra káwọn ọmọ yín lè mọ̀ pé yín níyá wọn púpọ̀ nínú ìyá bẹ́ ṣe ń pariwo àwọn ọmọ yín ò lè bá yín sọ̀rọ̀ a lot of parents the way you shout your children cannot even talk to you. Púpọ̀ nínú yín ẹ ti disoje mọ́ ọmọ yín lọ́wọ́ tán lè bá yín sọ̀rọ̀. A lot of you have become too much shouting that your child cannot even talk to you. Ẹ fọkàn yín balẹ̀, ẹ fara yín balẹ̀, kẹ jẹ́ ọ̀rẹ́ fọmọ yín. Mr. Abdullahi Adam says, all you are saying is in the Quran and Bible. God bless you. Thank you very much. Jade's Design Culture, thank you very much. She says the issue is very sensitive. It's very sensitive and very delicate. If a woman decides to choose her work around her children's school time and refuse to do all these 24/7 job, people say she is complacent, that she's the lazy type. That's right. That's our society for you. And but the real reason why some ladies do minimal work is to be there for their kids. Trust nobody with the upkeep of your child. Thank you very much. God bless you. A lot of men will tell their wives they can't work, even in the UK, even in Nigeria. They will say you should go to shop. They will open Nigeria will even open a shop. They will tell you to be there. While you are there, you are going to do Solomon Kinde. Your child comes, is playing ball on the street, entering people's house. Please. Don't let your children be entering people's house without you knowing where they are entering. There's many sick people and pedophiles out there. There's many people who are sick in their brain out there. Please, guide your children. That is why God has given them to you. I know you cannot be there 24/7, but if your child knows how to talk to you, your child knows to be your friend, your child knows to open up to you, your child knows their private part is theirs to keep and nobody must touch it, and if anybody touches it and tell them not to say, they are allowed to talk to you, they are allowed to say it to only you, then the abuse will not go for too long unnoticed. The abuse will not traumatize the child to the extent whereby the child will become gay or lesbian. Please, efa mori mora, eye pariwo mo awon omo yin, e je ore si awon omo yin tabi fun awon omo yin, e je ko omo yin ko le so nkan to ba nsele fun yin, e bere oro lowo awon omo yin. Elomi ani ohun o kin bere oro lowo omo ohun tori ko ma ba dabi pe boya ohun fe mo idi nkan to nsele nile onile mo idi nkan to nsele nile onile.